If you are planning a trip for spring break, we have tips to keep bedbugs from returning home with you, even if you're planning a trip beyond spring break. Bedbug specialist Doug Waslow joining us in studio. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
This is a growing problem.
It's a problem that hasn't stopped growing in the last 5 to 6 years, and it's something that, you know, people should be aware of when they're going on holidays or they're going to visit different places. It doesn't matter what kind of place you go to, there could be bed bugs.
Okay, how easy is it for us to get those bed bugs traveling with us and coming back home with us? How does this happen?
Well, bed bugs are hitchhikers, so they like to hitch a ride with us back, usually in our luggage. What'll happen is they'll get into your suitcase, you'll take them home, you won't know that you have them, you'll bring them into your home, and then next thing you know is you have a nasty problem.
How do you avoid having them get into your suitcase then? How do you avoid having them come
home
with you?
Well, what you want to do, it depends, it doesn't matter where you're going, whether you're going to a hotel or whether you're going to, to visit somebody or you're renting a place. What you want to do first is you want to make sure that you survey and take a look at the area when you first get there. And one of the ways to do that is check the bed, check the mattress, check the, check the headboard, take the headboard off. A lot of hotels, the headboards come off the wall. Pull them off and take a look and see.
But you brought this, but you see, and maybe you can explain this while I show this to people at home. These are bed bugs inside a little vial here.
Yes.
These things are so small, so how can you actually make sure that when checking for them that you're going to end up, accomplishing the task that you set out to do?
Well, and that's the difficult part. The one thing you want to look for when you go into a place, when you go into maybe a hotel or something like that, is look for signs. You want to look for, brown marks, which are the fecal deposits, or blood stains. You want to look for signs that they're there. When you pull off, a mattress cover or you pull off a headboard, if there's bed bugs there or have been there, you'll see the black marks. It'll look like pepper. It's like little spotting along there. Might be a sign that, there was or still is bed bugs in the area.
So if you do have a bed bug infestation, what is the best way then to deal with them?
Best thing you want to do if you, after you come home from vacation, first thing you want to do is, we always say, take your clothes, throw them in the dryer for at least 15 minutes on a high enough heat that won't wreck the clothes.
Don't wash them first?
Don't wash them. Throw them in the heat because heat will kill the bed bugs. Keep the suitcase somewhere. Don't bring it into the house.
Uh-huh.
Leave the suitcase in the garage. If you do have a problem and something happens and you do find out that you have bed bugs, call a professional. Doing them on your own, trying to treat them at home, they're so small, they spread so quickly, they multiply so quickly, you could just end up increasing the problem.
If they get into your luggage, it sounds as if you should just throw that piece of luggage away.
You could throw that piece of luggage away if you find that you had bed bugs. That's a good thing to do. You also can, there's a way to heat up the luggage. There's places you can take it.
Heat will kill it.
Heat will kill it.
Cold will preserve it.
Yeah. Cold, yeah, the problem with cold is that when bed bugs are, they're exposed to cold in a laboratory setting, they will die.
Mm-hmm.
But what the problem with bed bugs is if they're inside clothing, inside furniture, it acts like an insulation and they won't die from the cold.
How do these things develop?
Well, what happens is, the bed bugs they're nocturnal. They feed on humans. That's basically what they like to do. They're like mosquitoes. They feed on blood. So when they do that and then they multiply, they lay eggs. They grow. You can get bed bugs. They can go from egg to adult within 3 weeks if there's a proper food source, which of course we don't like to talk about. But can cause a lot of stress in a person's life.
Yeah, it's brutal.
It is.
We've had
many people that it can cause a lot of hardship. When you have to throw out furniture, beds, it can be very traumatic.
Well, listen, thanks for coming in to give us the lowdown on
this.
And hopefully it'll help people to avoid getting them. For more information on today's interview, just go to our website, click on to news links. Doug Waslow, thanks very much for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
It's a pleasure.